Hello children, in the previous video we learned to estimate area using grid paper. In this video we will learn more about it through some interesting examples. Raju and Bablu are watching TV at Bablu's house.
Painting competition has been announced in Champapur. All the contestants have to make unique paintings. The most unique painting will be rewarded.
This is being shown in the news on TV.
Raju, why don't we make a painting on a leaf?
Bablu said to Raju.
Yes, Bablu, this is a very good suggestion. Let us both find one leaf and then whichever leaf is bigger, we will together make a beautiful painting on it.
Raju told Bablu. Both friends began to find leaves outside Bablu's house. Both Bablu and Raju found one leaf each.
Bablu, we should use the bigger of these two leaves to make our painting.
Raju told Bablu.
But how will we find that out?
Bablu asked Raju.
All we need to do is to find the area of these two leaves. The leaf which has more area is bigger.
Saying this, Raju created outlines of both the leaves using a pencil on a grid paper.
But Raju, the areas enclosed by the outline of these leaves have some full squares, some half, some more than half, and even some less than half squares. Then how are we going to find their area?
Bablu asked Raju.
It is very easy. Can you tell me how many full squares are there in the area of the first leaf?
Raju asked Bablu.
8 squares.
Bablu quickly counted. Raju wrote down the number of full squares in this way.
Now, can you tell me how many half squares are there in the area of the first leaf?
Raju asked. Bablu looked closely and said,
6 squares.
6 half squares. We can even write them equal to 3 full squares.
Raju added 3 to the number of full squares previously written.
And now, finally, can you tell me how many squares are more than half in the area of the first leaf?
Raju asked.
2 squares.
Bablu said excitedly.
Absolutely right. We'll count them as full squares.
Now Raju added 2 more to the number of full squares.
We will not count any squares which are less than half. Now look, Bablu, the area of the first leaf has a total of 8, add 3 plus 2 or 13 squares. In other words, there are 13 squares in the area of the first leaf. Bablu, can you now use this process to find out how many squares are there in the area of the second leaf?
Raju told Bablu. Children, can you help Bablu in finding the answer? If you wish to, you may stop the video and find the answer. The area of the second leaf has 10 full squares, 4 half or 2 full squares and 4 more than half squares. And there are some less than half squares which we will not count. In this way, there are 10 add 2 plus 4 or 16 squares in the enclosed area of the second leaf. In other words, there are 16 squares in the area of the second leaf. Bablu also found the answer to this question just like you.
Raju, there are 16 squares in the area of the second leaf and 13 squares in the area of the first leaf. This means that the second leaf is larger than the first leaf.
Bablu told Raju.
Well done, Bablu. We came to know which is the biggest leaf, and you also learned to find the area using a grid paper. Now, let us quickly take part in the competition by painting a beautiful picture on this bigger leaf.
The two friends made a beautiful painting on the second leaf. Children, in this video, we learned more about estimating area using grid paper through some interesting examples. In the next video, we will look at some of the misconceptions related to this.